I told you, uni means one. So there are some living things that have only one cell in their body. So the correct answer here is yes. Here are some examples. Remember one unicellular organism we've already seen last class. What is this? Milind, what is this? What I've drawn here? We discussed last class.
Amoeba.
Correct. And then here are some more examples. Here, which you can see at the bottom, these are bacteria. They come in different shapes. You can see some are circular, some are rod shaped, some are spiral. Even viruses, they come in so many shapes, so many sizes. An interesting thing is this virus you see here, na? You get the common cold. So if we get wet in the rain, or we sometimes when we wash our hair and it's too cold, we start sneezing, na? And we get a runny nose and all of that. We get a common cold. So that common cold happens because of this virus. So it's a type of virus that causes common cold. So these also, you can see there's so many shapes, so many sizes, even with bacteria. There's another thing called paramecium. So these are some unicellular organisms. Uni means one. And cellular means cell. It has the whole organism has only one cell. Remember last class we discussed that our body has trillions of cells. So many cells we have. But there are some living things that have only one cell in their body. So whatever work has to happen, they have to grow, they have to eat, they have to, whatever they eat, they have to break that down, they have to respire. All this work happens in that one cell. And we saw unicellular organisms, multicellular organisms, these are the more common ones. And common, why? Because they are made up of so many cells and they are visible to our naked eye. Unicellular organisms we can't usually see with our naked eye, right? Because we discussed that cells are so small, in the range of micrometers, and even though they are microscopic, you need a microscope to see them. That's why most of us answer no for do you think the previous poll, right? If you think that cells can exist with just one cell in their body. We think so because we can't see them because they're that small. But there are unicellular